On this edition of Inside Blue Hose Football, Presbyterian College earned the win against Campbell on Saturday night in a fun one at Bailey Memorial Stadium. With a win under their belt, they'll look to get another one at home this Saturday night against Cumberland. We'll break down both of those games with Coach, check out the highlights, take a look at Coach's Corner, and a whole lot more. All that ahead on this edition of Inside Blue Hose Football. Welcome to Inside Blue Hose Football. I'm your host, Ryan Real, with the coach, Tommy Spangler. Coach, got to feel good this week. You got the win against Campbell 28-16 at home.
It was great, Ryan, to go in the locker room after a good win and just see the enjoyment of those of our players. Mm-hmm. You know, that was the best thing that happened. And we played well at times. Mm-hmm. You know, we still got a lot of things that we need to improve on. But, you know, I told the guys afterwards, we'll enjoy it Saturday night. I always kid with them. There's nothing like Clinton on a Saturday night after a good win. But, you know, we enjoyed it Saturday night, got back to reality on Sunday and in preparation this week for a good Cumberland team.
One thing we talked about in weeks past, you did the little things. You won the turnover battle. You won in penalties. And you were able to respond when Campbell was able to look like they were going about to do something.
Well, early in the game, they got a big play on us, and we held them to a field goal,
that
which
first
was
drive,
big.
Yeah.
And then we answered with some explosive plays on offense, which helps. You know, I would have much rather put them away in the third quarter when it was 21-3. It seemed like for a long time.
Sure,
you know,
sure.
I think one more touchdown might have sealed the deal for good. But you know, you got to give Campbell some credit. They kept battling and came back, and then we answered again, got some takeaways, and it was a good night. It was a good college football game. I was proud of our kids, proud of the effort, proud of the resiliency of bouncing back the way we've lost for 2 weeks. So, you know, a lesser group of guys, a lesser group of coaches, we'd have had a hard time, but they responded, and I'm proud of them.
And you did get that touchdown to salt the game away late from the Big South Conference Freshman of the Week.
How about that? Mark Robinson from Lee County High School in Leesburg, Georgia. What a great story he's becoming. And really running the ball hard. And I guess he's got 3 touchdowns now maybe on the year or something like that. And just doing an outstanding job. We got to probably just got to give it to him more. That's the only mistake we're making.
Good problem to have, and certainly a lot of highlights to check out this week. Let's go ahead and start with our offensive highlights from the win against Campbell.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
Here's some really good highlights on offense, Ryan. You know, we continue to improve. I'm proud of our guys. You know, they're going out to practice and working hard. This was early in the game. We needed a big first down here. It was third down. Ben checks us into a speed option. You can see he's, you know, he gets it out on the perimeter, makes a nice move, makes a guy miss a tackle. And, you know, he's a hard-nosed kid. You know, he's going to continue to run hard and be physical. And he's that kind of quarterback. You know, he's just a guy that's going to put us in the right place. Ben's a fourth-year player from Franklin County, Georgia, and been a good player for us right here. And, you know, you notice we're running a little bit more option this year, and I think he's that kind of quarterback that can get us in the right plays, make good decisions. He's got enough athleticism to make some people miss. Here we are driving it down the field and in good field position, and We give it to that good freshman right there, Mark Robinson, who breaks, you know, seems like 4, 5, 6 tackles right there. Good job up front by the offensive line. And there again, Mark is a true freshman, but he looks like he's a senior. You know, he's just a big old kid and well put together. He's the kind of guy that spends extra time in the weight room, does workouts with Groney. on his own, and just really proud of him. And he loves playing football, mm-hmm. and just got to keep getting some more of those kind of guys. Here we are putting Riley Hilton in motion. This was kind of a unique play. We were throwing a screen, and it tipped back to Ben, and Ben was just savvy enough to catch the ball and catch his own mm-hmm. deflected pass, so to speak, and turn it up and get some good positive yards for a first down. You know, and we were talking earlier, these are the kind of things, you know, when these kind of things start happening, you feel pretty good mm-hmm. about how the night's going to go. And that was good play there. Of course, here's our guy, you know, kind of the catching a screen pass out the backside. Really good call by Coach Vard. And Torrance actually loses his shoe. And when he lost his shoe, I thought for sure he was going to get walked down. But he broke about four or five tackles and took the play some 60, 70 yards. I don't know exactly what it was. But what a heck of a play. That's just instincts. Mm-hmm. You know, I'd like to say I coached him to do this, or the coaches coached him to do this. We got some good blocks out there. Jarius Duncan was out there blocking, and you know, just a great run and a fantastic play. That's it. You know, three games in a row, he's made a big play. Mm-hmm. Just really proud of him and kind of job he's doing. And here we are, kind of in our heavy set and our inverted bone, so to speak. And we just play action pass to Damian McGee, and Ben puts it on the money, and Damian breaks some tackles. It's amazing, you know, what you can do after you catch the ball if you just become a running back. And that's what he did and turned it into a big play. You can see from this shot right here, Ben does a great job of reading the run, pulling it, and then obviously putting a strike right on
where it needed to go.
Exactly. And then Damian finished it from there, and that's, you know, what they call yak, yards after catch, mm-hmm. rack, run after catch. That's big for us, and that was a heck of a play. Damien's out of Jacksonville, Florida. It's nice when you got highlights.
Mm-hmm. And, yeah, absolutely.
And here we are. I believe this was late. We jet motion and give it back to Mark, and you know, you see Mark plugging up in there and gets a nice gain, 12, 15 yards. This was when it was late a little mm-hmm. bit. We were needing to score. We were needing to kind of put Campbell away. They weren't going away, so we had to kind of put them away. And you know, it's nice to kind of wear a defense down. Some good blocking up front. He cuts it back, and you know, does a good job.
Offensive highlights, Coach. Career day for a lot of guys, including the quarterback Benchy. Great to see. All right, on the other side of the ball, the defense stepped up a number of times on Saturday in the win. Let's check it out with our defensive highlights of the week.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
Here we go on defense. What a great stop early in the game. I wish they would have never gotten down there, but this was big. And they kind of bootleg out the back door, look for a guy. Robert Baker's in good coverage, and Grant Bottle has a good hit right here. You know, and if you notice, I don't know, that 11 that came in for him sure was a good quarterback mm-hmm. and productive, Ryan, but I'm not sure this lick might have dazed seven and may have put him out of the game. I'm not really sure. I noticed he didn't play much after this, but just good pursuit. Guys playing fast, guys having fun, playing the game the way it's meant to be. Campbell puts a guy in motion, and we come on a blitz on a third down call. And, you know, Nick Moss just pours through the A-gap mm-hmm. right here, and back has nowhere to go.
Good to have him back.
It is good to have him back. We lost him there against Citadel. But, you know, when you execute on defense, you play hard on mm-hmm. defense, you play assignment steady, you got a chance to be pretty good. Here we are with just good pass rush up front. We get some good push in the middle from Michael Branch, and then you see Brian Washington coming from the outside, kind of falling in. Good coverage by the back end, the linebackers and the DBs right there. So it's good to get a minus yardage play. Here's Eli Turner come in for Robert Baker, who went out with a knee injury, and that was a turning point in the game. You know, they had kind of tightened it up a little bit, and this big interception from the backside, you can see it, good angle right there. Eli used to be, doesn't look like he was an offensive player right there at one time, but mm-hmm. I wish he would have made that guy miss and scored a touchdown. But great play by Eli, mm-hmm. just a true sophomore. Campbell puts, you know, they started moving on us a little bit late, trying to throw it a little bit more. Obviously, we had a good lead, and they needed to come back. And, you know, one thing we got to do is improve our fourth down or our fourth quarter performance. You know, sometimes it's hard to stay focused. Malachi Brown did a heck of a job. You know, Kenny Coleman's mm-hmm. been out. Malachi came in, played right corner. Malachi didn't play in the first game against Wake Forest. They tested him, and you know that. You were there and watched it. They went after him because we were rotating coverage a good bit and, you know, pulling our free safety over to the trip side and so forth, leaving him on an island. And you know, Campbell realized Kenny Coleman wasn't playing, so they went after Malachi Brown, and he did a nice job all night. I was proud of him.
Some big plays there. They made some turnovers, and special teams made a turnover themselves. Let's check it out with our special team highlights from this week.
Ryan, here's a group that doesn't get a lot of credit, you know, is our special teams guys. They put in a long hours in meetings, film study, practice time. This was Dirk Curitan, a true freshman, who returned this kickoff to get us good field position early in the game. I was proud of him. We had just put him on the team as kind of an off returner. Number four was the other returner. So they didn't want to kick it
right.
to him.
They
didn't
want
to kick
terrible.
It to Torrance. So they kicked it over to young, true freshman Dirk Curitan out of Butler High School in Charlotte, and he did a great job. Had some good blocks up front. We have practiced this more than we need to, kickoff return, if that makes sense. Mm-hmm. But we have gotten better. Here's a great effort. You know, Timmy doesn't quite catch this ball perfect, but it ends up being a good kick because it knuckleballs down through there. The guy has a little trouble fielding it, and we pour through. You can see we're pouring through nice right there. And I believe, you know, Antonio Leroy out of Albany, Georgia, Monroe High School, did a great job. Our backside, from this angle, you can tell that the right side of our coverage did a good job of, so to speak, staying at home and covering the field backside. We're getting off some blocks. We're pouring through, and you know, had the ball inside the 10. So, you know, Brett Norton pinned him down several times. That kickoff had him inside the 10. You can see Brett, he just bombs one here. Not quite as deep as I'd like, but we get a turnover.
Yep.
You know, and that was a crucial time of the game. Brant Cameron recovered this one, and, you know, just a big play, and, you know, didn't go as noticed as some of the other turnovers, but a huge turnover for us. Great job by the punt team and getting down and covering it up.
Coach, you had positive takeaways in all three phases of the game, but you got the win. What does that do for your team?
Well, obviously it gives us some confidence, but we got to stay real with it and know that we can continue to improve, and that's what it's going to take. You know, with a good Cumberland 4-0 team coming in here, we're going to have to continue to build. Wofford's right around the corner. Our Big South Conference opponents are right around the corner, so we're going to have to continue to build. But it's nice to go into a film session, Ryan, and correct mistakes after a win as opposed to a loss.
Right, especially when things we have talked about on this program, I was able to see. I mean, you could see the improvement like we talked about.
I hope so. I think so. And like you said, a lesser group of guys, the resiliency was there, and that's what I was proud of. The coaches continue to work. The players continue to work. And obviously, we showed some, you know, it showed that it paid off. So I was proud of that.
Your team will have a chance to build on it, like you said, with a nationally ranked NIA team, Cumberland, coming in here this Saturday. We're going to talk about the Phoenix. We're going to talk about the injury report. We're going to talk about Coach's Corner with Mitch Doolittle. And we're also going to do a lot more when we come back on this edition of Inside Blue Hose Football.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge. And now, with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Coca-Cola, taste the feeling, and by Adidas, here to create.
Welcome back to Inside Blue Hose Football. Now it's time for the collision of the week, and if you paid attention to the defensive highlights, you might know what it is. And either way, we'll watch it again. With our collision of the week brought to you by Nichols Automotive, your one-stop shop for all your automotive service needs, and Yokohama Tires.
Collision of the week is brought to you by Hanna Heating and Air.
This was a big hit by, you know, you can see right here, Grant Bottle comes in for our collision of the week, Ryan. And we had several, actually. We hadn't had many in two games, but we got a couple in this game. But this seemed to be the best one. Like I said, I'm not so sure it didn't knock number seven out of the game a little bit. And But it was a good play. Rocks back in there, plays the game the way it's meant to be played.
All right, Coach. Well, with the collision of the week, let's transition to our palmetto bone and joint injury report.
Well, I wouldn't tell you the truth anyway, Ryan, sure, in case Cumberland's watching. But yeah, we're fairly healthy. Mm-hmm. We had some dings and dangs. Robert Baker went out in toward the middle of the second quarter, beginning of the third quarter with a knee issue. He'll be back. Mm-hmm. Nothing serious. Some ankles here and there, those type of things. Mm-hmm. But we continue, I hope, to get some guys back. Said Frazier didn't play. He's going to play this week. Damian McGee, who had a long run, has battled some leg issues. So we're continuing. Kenny Coleman, we're continuing to get a little healthier.
That's great to hear. And you know, you played three games against some good teams. You're going to have those injuries. But you got a top-flight medical staff, and great to see those guys coming back. All right. Well, there's a lot of things that goes on behind the scenes, the way you coaches look at film. Let's get a little bit of insight to that with our Coach's Corner.
Coach's Corner is brought to you by Jeff Smith, Allstate Insurance of Clinton. You're in good hands with Allstate and Jeff Smith.
Hi, I'm Mitch Doolittle, defensive coordinator, linebackers coach. Welcome to this week's edition of Coach's Corner. Today, we're going to be looking at a critical play in the game from this past weekend versus Campbell. Eli Turner intercepted a pass from Campbell's quarterback at a critical point in the game and got the ball back to our offense's hands, and which eventually led to a score. Okay, as you can see, we call this a scoreboard shot, and what this says is Presbyterian, we're up 21-10 with 4 minutes to go fourth quarter with 6.5 minutes to go roughly. So it's a big time in the game. Campbell has the football. You see him driving at midfield, heading in. So they just got us first down. If you look up at the top of the screen, you can see the chains moving. They're not even set yet, so they just got a first down. We knew by the scouting report they would be going fast on first down, trying to catch us off guard. But you see, we're ready to play. We have our huddle call in. The guys are ready in their stances. We're in good football position across the board. And with the double stack set, we have a certain call that between the corners and the safeties to allow the safeties, to take the inside part of the route. And Eli Turner is up top, and Rock Yassin is up top as well at the corner position. They are passing off these two vertical routes right here. We get good push from the defensive line, trying to condense the pocket, get in the quarterback's face. And then Eli maintains proper leverage and steps right in front of the quarterback's pass. Anticipated it well, knew from film study that this was a favorite concept of theirs. And like we said, at a critical time, got the ball back into our offense's hands across midfield. Every game we try to say on defense, we either want to score or set up our offense to score with a short field. And that's what we did right there. And it was an exciting time. You see the guys are excited down here at the bottom of the screen. Jaycee Yeldell, Malachi Brown, a lot of fun and a big play.
I'm a random windstorm. Shaky, 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 shaky. Shaky, shaky. And if you got cut rate insurance, you could be picking up this tab yourself. So get Allstate. You could save some cash and be better protected from mayhem like me.
Watching a cow.
Oh, what's it doing?
Impressions.
Power up your morning with a new 300-calorie egg white grill. Only at Chick-fil-A.
There once was a family, a lot like this one. And they were traveling far away where there were no Bojangles. The family needed breakfast, but they got a late start. Pulled up to a drive-thru of a strange restaurant, and a loud voice boomed. We stopped serving breakfast at 10 a.m.
Oh, honey.
At Bojangles, we've always served breakfast all day. Come in for a Cajun filet biscuit today. Bojangles, it's bow time.
If you're considering joint replacement surgery, ask yourself these questions. Is my orthopedic surgeon experienced in joint replacement? Does he listen to my concerns? Explain all my options? Will he manage my pain? Will he help me regain the active life I want? The orthopedic surgeons of Palmetto Bone and Joint are proud members of Newberry Hospital's award-winning joint replacement team. We're among the best in the state and nation for hip and knee replacement. You have a choice. Palmetto Bone and Joint.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Hannah Heating and Air, Nichols Automotive, and by Printers Associates. Next week's preview is brought to you by The Bud Group. Great people, smart service.
Well, Coach, welcome back. We got a big game this weekend, the 21st in the NAIA, Cumberland Phoenix coming to town, another night game.
Yeah, they've got a good football team, Ryan, and they're coached well. In fact, their head coach, Donnie Suber, played for me at Georgia Southern. And then Donnie was here with us at Presbyterian. Donnie was an assistant coach here at Presbyterian for several years and was down at Newberry. So he knows the area well, would love nothing better than beat his whole ball coach in there. So we know we're going to get a good team that, and you can tell watching them in film, they've improved every week. Obviously, 4-0, they're playing with a lot of confidence.
Just beat Edward Waters. They're 2-2, so it's not like they've been all over. They've gotten some wins, and Fred Marshall, also a 2014 PC graduate, also on staff.
Fred played in the secondary for me my first year back, and has done a really good job coaching their secondary. So Those guys will be excited coming back to Clinton.
It's so interesting how small the coaching fraternity is and how connected you guys are.
And how about this? The starting quarterback, Desmond Huntley, who's an incredible player. Mm-hmm. This tells you how old I'm getting. Mm-hmm. I coached his dad at Georgia Southern.
Wow.
Albert Huntley. Wow. So I'm sure Albert's telling his son, "Hey, Desmond, whip old Coach Spangler for me." But it's going to be a heck of a challenge. They got a really good football team, and they're athletic, and I compare it. I told our guys it's scary. I compare it a lot to that Florida Tech game last year.
Sure. That was a and so you got Cumberland coming in, and because I think, you know, rightly or wrong, people can see that schedule and see Wofford coming up, and and Wake Forest and Citadel and all that.
Yeah, and there's a fine line. You can't beat it to death by overplaying it too much. Mm-hmm. I mean, Cumberland's a good team. If we don't play well, we can lose. If we play
That's
well,
college football. Yeah.
Exactly. If we play well, we'll have a shot. And we've got to worry as much about PC as we do about Cumberland and do what we need to do to continue to improve and get better and all those kind of things. So, yeah, there's a fine line between, sure, we've got to make sure our kids respect Cumberland. Mm-hmm. At the same time, let's worry about us and let's keep getting better.
One thing that I really took away from that Campbell game is like we talked about with Robinson and Maribel, the ability McGee had that play too, to kind of game breakers. Well, the ability to break plays and keep them going.
It is, and it's fun. And you know, I'm hoping it brings some more people in the stands mm-hmm. because it's fun to watch guys make explosive plays and exciting offense. And I thought our offense did that at times. We got to be a little bit more consistent. Mm-hmm. Thought our kids played hard. We're dressing out everybody. Our whole football team dresses out, and mm-hmm. people are excited. And we just gotta keep building on it, you know. And then it was a good start.
Especially like when you said you never know when you next man up, and you get a guy like Malachi Brown who makes a big turnover last week and plays well
and
today.
And has never played.
Yeah,
has
exactly. Never played. So yeah. The idea that you know you might see somebody you've never seen before do something great.
Let's hope so. And we just got to keep building and keep getting these young guys reps and playing time, and hopefully they just keep improving as they go.
And how important was that against Campbell to establish the run? You guys were able to do that early on, and I think that really set you guys up for success.
I don't care whatever level, Ryan. You know this. I mean, high school, college, pro, you've got to establish a run mm-hmm. to be productive and win championships. So we need to probably actually throw it a little bit better, even though we did have a screen, but it mm-hmm. was about a five-yard pass. It went 70 yards. And then another pass that went about 60 yards. It wasn't very long. But we got to be able to throw it downfield, convert on third down a little bit better. But keep improving on the run game, which has been pleasing.
Absolutely. All things to look for this weekend. It's Cumberland at 7 o'clock, and it's family day. Coach, it was so nice. Beautiful weather this time of year, but last week you had the parachute dropping the ball.
How about
off
that?
Was that not awesome? That was awesome. Retired military personnel, and it's just such an atmosphere on home games.
It is. It's a beautiful, you know, Jake and Scott do just a wonderful mm-hmm. job of painting the field, and Patrick and Mac and all those guys in maintenance. Grounds crew does a good job with that stadium. I mean, all that's part of, you know, getting our players excited mm-hmm. and going. And then also people got to understand that we've got recruits here,
sure.
you know,
yep.
that are making decisions about PC. And it's nice to come when we've got fans in the stands, we've got good game ops, we've got good loud music. Having fun, enjoying life, and hopefully people will keep coming back.
Can't wait. 7 o'clock this Saturday against Cumberland. Well, that'll do it for us. For the coach, Tommy Spangler, I'm Ryan Rial. We'll see you next time on Inside Blue Hose Football.
Inside Blue Hose Football was brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. And by Self Regional Healthcare.